put your hand out there. Make some noise. Hype it up.
Enjoying the Lord on today. Amen. Praise God. It's so good to be in God's house. Pastor certainly solicits your prayers today. Praise Lord. As always, as I share with a few of you who I talked to on the course of the week, ever since the consideration was given for your pastor to walk in the office of a bishop, being on Bishop's watch, praise the Lord, it has become very intense. Praise the Lord. That's just a consideration. Praise the Lord. So I'm asking the church to listen that you pray for us. Amen. Praise God. I want to ask those of you who are prayer warriors who can pray. Please pray for Pastor's family. Praise God. Yeah. Not only is it just spiritual stuff taking place, but also not only has my father been dealing with some things, my mother has as well, and she solicits the prayers of the saints. I had some of you in my heart to go and talk to who I know that God has called you to a life of prayer. But praise remember Lady Smith as well, too. Amen. So we greatly appreciate that. So it's just a lot to carry, but I don't believe that God gives us any more than we can bear. Praise the Lord. And I've always shared with the Lord that I desire whatever He wants me to walk in, I want to walk in that. I don't want to do it half-heartedly, praise the Lord. I don't want to be one of those preachers who have a title, but then there's no manifestation. There's no evidence. There is no works, praise the Lord, behind it. And so I think during the season, God is just trying to teach me how to handle the weight, because He will not add weight unless there's structure. Praise the name of the Lord. So in my heart, I feel like God's got to be happy with some stuff, because the weight is quite intense, praise the Lord. And I won't do it today, but I'm looking at a couple of things, praise the Lord. And one of the sermons I was looking at was the difference that 1 degree makes. Because at 280, I feel good today, praise the Lord. This particular message, I need to talk to you, praise the Lord. That one I'm going to preach, hey, hallelujah. But 211 degrees, is water is just hot. At 212, it's boiling. And it is important for us as believers to know that... It's important for us to remember that it's necessary to go beyond that someone was talking about a little bit earlier, I think it was Elder Harris, how you feel. Because that 1 degree can make a difference in your life. If you look at track and field or study the Olympics, most of the races are won, I'm talking about less than a second, a split. I mean, it's just a split hair. And so I want you to know that when it gets intense, when the pressures and the cares of life seem like they're all coming in on you, it's just go a little further. That's all God wants you to know, because your blessing is right there. You got no one to tell you that. And if your mind is not conditioned, you will mess yourself up. Praise the Lord. But God is right there. But I want to continue this morning talking about the benefit of having the Holy Spirit. As we've been dealing with that particular series, and we've been through revival, had a wonderful time. And I just want to talk some more. One in particular, I skipped over a little bit, because there's one that I want to deal with a little bit today, titled The Discerning of Spirits. Because you have people in the church that are newsy and call it the discerning of spirits. You have people in the church that meddle but call it discerning of spirits. Praise the Lord. And so we want to talk just for a few moments. Thank God for our visitors. That's why we want to talk just a few moments. 1 Corinthians chapter 12, beginning at verse 1, writer says this. He says, "Now concerning spiritual gifts, brethren, I would not have you ignorant." So God wants us to know. He says, "Ye know that ye were Gentiles carried away unto these dumb idols, even as ye were led." Now, I want to just digress just for a moment in verse 2 there. I think that, well, for me, what I see, Sister Diane, is the grace of God in that particular text. Because it's a reminder of what we were doing too. So many times as God delivers people, it is very easy for us to look down our nose at somebody else.
Amen.
Shane, that's not the God that I serve. Praise the Lord. God, the God that I serve is a God of compassion and love. Praise the Lord. And mercy. I know I'm not the only one who has been a recipient of his love and of his mercy. As a matter of fact, as one writer said, it is because of the Lord's mercies that we are not consumed. And it wasn't until I was mature enough in the spirit to understand that he was talking, Brother Hunter, about me. And it's not just one time, Dana, that I've experienced that. And so I've gotten to the place, Aaron, where I said, Brother Alice, great is God's faithfulness. I don't deserve to be standing before you today. Praise the Lord. It is God's grace and mercy. Yeah, there's no goodness of my own. It's not because I have the title of a pastor. It's not because some may put me on a pedestal. It is pastor because of God's faithfulness to his people. Amen. It is not because I have crossed all T's and dotted all I's. Great is God's faithfulness. It is not because I show up 52 Saturdays out of the year and keep what we understand as the Sabbath. It is God's faithfulness. I want the church to understand that. It doesn't have anything to do with the discerning of the spirits just yet, but God in his mercy always leaves something hidden within the text to help us appreciate his grace. Because the church always, Mama Gail, has to be reminded that if justice were to have its way, none of us, my dear sister, would be seated here. I often, Rabbi, have to remind the church that, guess what? I thank God that he has not revealed my true thoughts.
Yes.
Amen.
I know if some of you are, you praying right now that God doesn't show pastor. Praise the Lord. You ought to thank God. Don't worry about that, praise the Lord. You ought to thank God for grace today. Thank him for his mercy on today. Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Pastor Embry was talking on last week, and I was so blessed by her testimony. And listening to Elder Harris today, blessed by his testimony of where God brought him from. God could take a drug dealer. God could take a man who hired prostitutes. They worked for him, and the list goes on and on and on, and save him and make him an awesome gospel preacher. Come on, church. That's a good place to bless God. That's a good place. That's a good place to put your hands together. We clap because that's our way of celebrating God's greatness. That's our way of making a joyful noise unto the Lord. That's our way of saying that God can do what no man can do. Because I'm sure that there were people who looked at this young man and thought he would never be anything. But to see him today, oh, great is God's faithfulness. He's not the only one. I look at my family, where I've come from in Philadelphia. I was just there last week celebrating. Let me share this with you. Celebrating 50 years of my mother and father being married. That's a blessing. That's a blessing. That's a blessing. And I want to share this with the church. It doesn't make the Smith family better than anybody else. But at the same token, because you've been through some stuff and maybe your parents have been married for 50 years, don't make mine no better. Watch this now. And nor does it mean I need to sit down on the testimony God gave to my mom and dad. So excuse me while I thank God for giving Bishop and Lady Smith 50 years together. That's a blessing to be able to lay eyes on the lady that brought my parents together. I said, man, this is awesome. And then to have a phenomenal dad like Bishop Smith, who had a father who, I think the only appointment my grandfather kept was that he got my father here. For my father not to have an example other than Jesus Christ and raise 6 kids. I think you were talking last night about a spirit of laziness. Couldn't help but thank God for my father who always kept multiple jobs. Y'all know Bishop Smith. One of the things he detests, Hunter, is a lazy man. He would break it down Embry, and say, I loathe it. Bishop will come up with some words. I wouldn't even show in a dictionary. Because his work ethic was so high, so pure, and just set by God. But he taught us, Elder, how to work. how to take care of our families, not to push a responsibility off on anybody else that was ours. So I'm grateful today. I thank God for all of you, those of you who called or text Pastor in a loving way and said, if you don't get yourself up to Philadelphia, I appreciate it. So verse 3, wherefore I give you, he says, to understand that no man speaking by the Spirit of God calleth Jesus accursed. Boy, that's strong. That's strong. That's strong. And that no man can say that Jesus is the Lord but by the Holy Ghost. Now, you have got to, and I'm going to get to the discerning of spirits, but I've learned in my few short years of pastoring that I shouldn't rush the Word of God. What I find funny, Pastor Scott, is that most people don't rush when they get out of church the things that they're going to get into. Come on, talk to me, somebody. You get to the mall, you're taking your time because you're ministering to your flesh. Praise the Lord. Not there's anything wrong with going to the mall. Praise the Lord. Movies or anything else, but I want you to understand, when it comes to God, let's not rush. Take our time, because be quite honest with you, sometimes I these are my thoughts. Sometimes I just desire that God give us, Brother Jeff, a reminder that he's in control. Yes. So while we have rushed to the mall, just if he would just take air from us for 60 seconds. Wow. I guarantee you, when he gave it back, you'd be thanking him. Yes. Yes, but I'm grateful. Oh, Lord, yes, while I'm here, let me say this. It's on my mind. I thank him also. Some of you probably, last night, it was a reminder. I was driving, got in my car after men's fellowship, was coming down the driveway, and I saw Brother Swan, his son, his name slips my mind at memory at the moment, but I saw him come running up the driveway, and I was coming with my car, and I thank God, because the mirror used to be there, but I thank God that he ran and he saw my car just enough time to turn around and go back the other way, and I wasn't speeding, but I just said, just that quick, he could have been hit. Yeah. And then I thought about Sister Gail. I know the mirror's down, because she said, Elder, she texted me, said, Elder, show me the pictures, and said, I was just standing right in that position just moments ago. Tree came crashing down and just damaged the mirror. And I said, thank you, God. I know some of you can't get real excited because that wasn't your mother, but I thank God that he spared her life. Just that quick, because God has to remind us sometimes. He knows what he's doing. So I say all I have to say this. As I look at verse 3, don't think I forgot that your pastor, that verse means more to me than probably a lot of people, because I grew up in a church where they didn't believe in Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Taught vehemently against Jesus Christ.
Yes.
God in his mercy, as Elder was talking about being saved at 1 o'clock in the morning, filled me with the Holy Spirit in a church. Man, that's powerful to me. Praise Lord. You've heard my testimony. And so I know that even for me to say Jesus Christ, and I got another sermon too I'm going to be speaking to the church about concerning the sacred name, because I've been hearing a lot of things. I said, I need to just address that. But you got to know that I'll wait a whole year if God tells me to, because when I do it, I got to do it in love. I can't be like some of you who think you want to educate pastor or use the sacred name as a weapon, praise the Lord, all that kind of stuff. That's how I know the spirit behind it. I said, well, Lord, I got to wait till the right time. And when I say that, he wants me to die. When I get up, ain't nothing but love. Y'all are talking to me, praise the Lord. Yes, yes, yes. So that text there, verse 3 is good. I could talk all day about that. That's my life. He says, now there are diversities of gifts. Now there are diversities of gifts. I don't have a hold on this, Minister Tracy. Much as I think I know, God is still showing me. There's so much more to learn, because there are diversities of gifts, but the same Spirit.
Hallelujah.
That tells me a lot, Deacon Jason.
Yes, yes.
God manifests himself a number of different ways, Brother Jeff.
Yes,
and if I'm sensitive to the Holy Spirit, I'll pick up on it.
Yes, yes,
yes. Not, oh God, help me preach today. Yes. Not religion.
Yes.
Because you see, what religion will do is keep you doing the same stuff over and over and over again and cause you to become closed-minded.
Yes. Yes.
But relationship exposes you to more.
Yes. 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 Yes.
He says, verse 5, and there are differences of administrations,
yes,
but the same Lord.
Yes.
Amen, amen.
Ooh, church, I wish that you could go with Pastor today. I was thinking as I was meditating on this particular text before I got good and deep in it, and God was showing me how all of these labels that society has come up with for our churches, like the house of God. That's just the label. Like Full Gospel Baptist Church, that's just the label. Like Church of God in Christ, that's just the label. What really matters to God is that we are all a part of the body of Christ.
Amen.
Elder, you are talking today. I can't prepare it for y'all. I'm going to give my own self an offering. We have so many people who are bringing about division within the body of Christ. Because someone didn't come from your camp does not mean that God is not using them. I could talk about your experiences, but I think mine are better. God always, I mean, he has consistently been showing me how, guess what, church? New Bethel doesn't have it all. I know some of you feel like we do. Now, we got some great stuff in here. But there's so much more that God has to expose New Bethel to. Starting with your pastor. There's a lot more I want to share. I'll just talk with you about my pastor because that's appropriate for today. God, Sister Kiana, showed me this. That, watch this now. As I shared with the church some time ago, let's just say concerning Pastor Jamal Bryan's church. He's right up the street. Wonderful ministry. God's blessing tremendously.
Amen.
But understand this. There are specific people that are assigned to his ministry.
Yes.
And then after they have received whatever it is that God wants them to receive, they might move and go someplace else.
Yes.
Now, New Bethel, watch this. Now, watch this. The same way that can happen in this church, it can happen here.
Yes.
Look at this. Are we not all a part?
Amen.
Now, while I know we say it, and I'm getting some good amens, I'm telling you, it don't always feel good when the Holy Spirit starts performing the surgery. Because, and I need to say this, Mom, because if we're not careful, the very thing that'll be God will speak against.
That's right.
And watch this now, Deacon Jason. I know that New Bethel is a great place.
Amen.
But we're just a small fragment in the body. Praise the Lord. But I want you to see, God is preparing us for greatness.
That's it.
Amen.
He has called this church to be a pioneer. He has called this church, this assignment that New Bethel is on, is to help introduce.
Oh, God. Go ahead.
The Lord has things in his heart for this ministry that he is going to do. But it's outside of what you're used to.
Amen.
Church, I need for you to understand this.
Yes. Yes.
Because otherwise you'll start talking even against your pastor because you don't understand the direction that we're going in.
Right.
The best way that I can put it is, during this season, and I've struggled with how much I can share with you all, like God did Paul for, I think, in the space or the span of 3 years, God mentored him. Now, the reason he had, God, this is good. The reason he had to mentor him is because, watch this now, if God did not intervene, Paul would have gone to people that he grew up with, that he felt he could trust, and no doubt didn't see the vision that God had given to him. Because what happens is when you start to share the vision that God has given to you and it's not the proper time, people in their love will start speaking against what God gave to you, and because you love and respect them so much, you can get off course.
That's right.
Look around and don't get used to everybody that you see, Brother John.
That's right.
Let me ask you a question. Do you have your camera in your car? I'm going to need you to get it today because I need to take a picture of the church because it's not going to be the same.
Yes.
Real short. What's funny is I was driving to church this morning. And a little put that in my spirit and said, go see Brother Jonathan. Tell him to get his camera. And I was thinking, God, I don't have his number. You know, what if he don't bring it? God said, what did I tell you? So, okay, God. So that's why I asked you like that. So you got it. Please get it immediately after service. I need to take a picture of the members that are here. Real quick.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Now, I ain't talking about people visiting. I'm talking about the members. Because we're not going to stay where we are. I got one. I got two, three shots in my house, I believe, of the church.
That's right.
When, matter of fact, I can go back. Well, I got 2008, I got some others that are there. But God is letting us know it's not going to take him a long time to do what he's doing. Get this. Sherry, I'm so glad to see you. I'm so glad to see you, Kiana. Who else on the sister, Nicole? I'm so glad to see you. Where's Sister Raquel, the dead usher? Okay. I'm so glad to see them. And because they stay sensitive in the spirit.
Yes.
Those are, oh God, this is good. When I'm teaching on discernment, if anybody ought to get it, our ushers have got to get it.
That's right.
Because you all are the first ones that see people walk through that door. And please help Pastor Will. God, I'm sorry, y'all. I have studied about Elo's rattle off all the colleges he's been to. I haven't been at as many as he has, praise the Lord. I get a place and stay there. No, I'm messing with you. I'm looking at systematic theology, and it's helping me understand the gifts and why God gave them to the church. But I want the church to understand this. You cannot discern whether or not somebody has a relationship with Jesus based upon their outerwear. Let me tell you what happens, Pastor. I'll study and I'll have 3 points. But when I study a lot of times, I go so deep until he won't allow me to follow a script. I just gotta flow based upon what he, you know, okay. So I want people to know it's not that I don't know how to work and break that thing down. I got up and I was thinking, you know, it's Family and Friends Day. I want to impress somebody. How many of y'all know I'd rather follow God than me? So for those of you, see, when people come in, please don't judge them based upon how they look.
Amen.
I can't tell you how many people that I've met that are coming off the street that have a relationship with God.
That's right.
I've even seen people that were demon-possessed. Prophesy, sit right in the back. Where Chuck is sitting, sit right in the back and prophesy and tell me as the pastor what's happening in this church. Get up and leave. I'm just telling you, you know, for those of us that think we know everything there is to know about God.
Amen.
You know why I pass the New Bethel the way I pass the New Bethel? Because I'm convinced that all God wants me to do is share the word.
Amen.
What you do with the word, that's between you and Jesus.
Amen.
See, because if I ever go deeper than that and start trying to control you.
That's right.
We got a problem. I was listening to Brother Swan last night at Men's Fellowship. He was just overjoyed talking about his daughter. She's 4 years old and I think 6. And had been talking about the Lord and singing songs. And sometimes when they ask them why they singing like that, they say, you know, why they singing so loud? They say, well, Pastor sings it loud like that. But here's what I really like. You know, when you heard them discussing God at the table, they're having conversations that grown adults would have, but they're having it at their age.
Amen.
Pastor Embry, I could hear his heart last night as he was sharing, telling Deacon Jason, please keep teaching like you're teaching, because
amen.
I wish that my dad had talked to us like you're talking to your girls, helping them understand the relevance behind having a relationship with God. And I rejoice today because even though my daughter is in Kentucky and she's away from her mom and dad, I don't have to worry about Michaela because we have instilled some things in her. I don't care what her experience is, my daughter knows and has a relationship with God for herself. And when that's the case, you can be saved anywhere. The mistake we often make is, yes, the Lord told us don't forget to assemble ourselves. Yes, he did. But the real deal is, this is the temple. So I don't have to stress and worry about some of our young people that are getting ready to go to college. I know they're going to be kept. They got enough word in them to know right from wrong.
Yes.
New Bethel, are y'all ready for the experience?
Yes.
Now listen, Pastor. God, there's some scriptures I wish I could keep reading, but I'm going to just share it, Jeff. Watch this now. When we really mature, we won't have a problem doing, I'm going to use the ministerial staff as an example. These brothers and sisters are very knowledgeable. I would even venture to say that probably most of them probably know more than their pastor does. But the reality of it is, they would never step outside of their place and be disrespectful to their pastor because they know that the mantle to lead this church is on their pastor. Michael is 10. And because it's not my thing, Mikey knows more about sports than I do. He's called a self-testament. He's even said to me, Dad, you don't know what you're talking about. And Herb, I don't go off on some tangent talking about I'm your father. And Karen, I said, you know what, you're right. And I always end the conversation by saying this, I don't care. But God has shown me some revelation in his word through me dealing with my children. Because Mikey knows the subject matter. It still doesn't, he's not authorized to be me. He's not my father. I will always be his father, whether I study the stats or not.
That is so true.
So I'm not intimidated by him every morning when he gets up and see what else does he know? Who cares? The mantle is on me to be his father.
Amen.
He has figured out that if I submit to my dad, we go on places.
Yes,
then when I pick him up, what you want? We go to the store and we get it. But let him step out of line and start smelling himself, as my pop used to say to us. There'll be a different response.
That's right.
Woo! God. So there are, God, help me finish with this. There are, please, church, into it. Please embrace this. God is taking us places. I was sharing with someone. I said, man, there are things that I'm studying. I asked the ministers to do an assignment for me concerning even Isaiah, the 50th chapter. I said, because I'm looking, and I don't know about you all, but I get disturbed when I go to other places and I see that other people who happen to worship on Sabbath like us, they are so far ahead until it's scary. And I keep asking God, because he has called me to pastor a church during this generation, this time, and we are a, please listen to Pastor, we are a results-driven generation.
Amen.
Am I by myself?
No.
Okay.
No,
well, and there's nothing wrong with that. Now, I'm at a place in my life, Mama Gail, where if I keep doing something and I'm not seeing any results.
That's right. Go ahead.
Yes.
Go ahead. Make it true. Make it true.
There you go.
Because if I no more word than what I got time.
Yes.
But if I know anything about the Messiah, that man walked with some manifestation. Because watch this now, watch this. If it was just about knowledge, the rabbis would have got him.
Come on!
Because nobody knew more word than them jokers.
Nobody.
Anytime God can give one command and you come up with 600 additional, I mean, come, seriously, nobody can break apart a word like them. But Jesus will step up and come up on the scene. And not only would he know word, but manifestation would come behind. And he would play with their minds and say stuff like, but who do men say that I am? Oh, God, I feel like preaching today. Jesus. The way he separated himself from the pack was that he not only could walk up and discern the spirit, Pastor, he could, oh, you know enough word, man. I mean, he'd just play with him. And then all of a sudden, when he got ready, he would manifest. See, because I've never read where any rabbis healed anybody.
That's right.
I didn't read, even in the Old Testament, when you're dealing with some of the great leaders and whatnot, now God may have worked miracles through them, but it's just a few of them in comparison to Christ's healing record. Watch this now. And if I study history closely enough, oh, their only assignment was to be a type of what was coming.
That's right. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Robert, Jesus, this generation I pastor here, Jesus is a results Geneva-driven individual. Let me give you just a little bit of scripture so you don't think I made this up. Before I give you that scripture, I'm going to get a little closer. I'm going to show you some real life examples. My father is a third time cancer survivor. You know how I got good at prison? Bishop walks. See, people think that they saw me become national officer and they thought that God had just given faith to me at that level. God was taught faith by my father. And it wasn't so much him opening up the word to teaching me stuff as much as I saw what he did. And when he got sick, Jaquetta, he did nothing but confess that word. And he kept confessing it, until he go back to the doctors and they said, well, you know what, we don't see it anymore. Cancer try to come back again. And watch this. The other thing that we did, help me, church. Good Lord, have mercy. Listen. When you start going through things, number one, don't tell everybody your business. Number two, if you really love your family members, don't let everybody talk to them.
Amen.
Here's what I mean by that. My brothers and sisters were on watch. Everybody that called the house to speak to Bishop, I had some people even say, I had some good friends even say stuff to my face about my dad, and if I wasn't saved, let's just say I'd be on the front page of the newspaper. I had one brother walk up and say, man, your dad looks bad. And see, I'm going to tell you about your pastor. God has always had me, April, have like a delayed response to stuff. And I used to wonder, Jason, why he did that to me. Because it wouldn't kick in, Jeff, until I was on 95. About a day later, and shoot, they would be like, did they just say to me, y'all know y'all not the only one? And I said, Tracy, I knew that was God. Mama Jean, I realize in serving God, even the devil sometimes give you a freebie, Ace. And I said, man, I know that was God. I know it was God. Because if I had been thinking at that particular time, I would have told him a few things. And I might even swung. I might even throw a kick. Praise God. I'm just being honest with you. I said, wow, thank you, God, for your grace. Yes. See, my point is people mean well, but not everybody knows what to say. And because I've studied the word long enough to know that words have life.
That's right.
God, come on, Smith. Lord, this is good today. Yes, it is. Go with me. Let me show you this. I know more word than what I got time. Let's go to Matthew chapter 11. Hurry up. Take your time. Hurry up. Come on. Let's do it. I want to show you something. I'll talk about results driven, and I'm going to get back to ratings. I hope. Matthew chapter 11. Y'all ready?
Yes,
Watch this. And it came to pass, when Jesus had made an end of commanding his 12 disciples, he departed thence to teach and to preach in their cities. Lord have mercy. I've always taught this text from this vantage point. For those of you who are worried about your husbands and your wives or your boyfriends, your girlfriends, whatever the case may be, and them coming to meet the Lord, don't worry about them. If you take care of God's business, what I saw in that text is he'll take care of yours. So he sends the disciples out, but he goes where they live. Because sometimes you can be too close to make a difference. Number 2, verse 2. Now when John had heard in the prison the works of Christ, he sent two of his disciples and said unto him, art thou he that should come, or do we look for another? Jesus answered and said unto him, go and show John again those things which ye do hear and see. Somebody say manifestation.
Manifestation.
He tried to figure out, is this the one? He's trying to figure out, I'm in the right place at the right time. He's trying to figure out, is there a season shift? You know what God is saying? Look for the manifestation. I started talking about Apostle Smith. You are manifestation. When you got sick, God came and healed you. So we see the gift of healing work. Okay. Sister Anna, you don't have to tell me. I already knew in the Holy Spirit what they were saying over your mother. We just kept praying the reverse. Your mom home yet? Listen, this is good. Lord, I wish I could say everything that's on my mind. It's just a job ready. Y'all know how I usually get that 5, 6, 7, 8. We're getting ready to go on. I'm gonna try that one more time. Sister, your mom come home yet?
No, sir.
She come home when?
Friday.
Okay. Right. Hold on. Hold on. I'm going to tell you, because you and I haven't talked, and I think it was God's will that we didn't talk. Now I can flow in the Holy Spirit. Okay. You can tell me if I'm lying. There are people who said that your mother wasn't going to make it.
Yeah.
There are people who had even told the family to prepare themselves for her funeral.
Wow. Yes.
How many of y'all know God has the last say? The purpose. Lord, this is good. Oh, let me finish here, and I'll get back to what just happened. When you look at when John asked the questions, and Jesus says, answer said, tell him this. Look at verse 5. He said, the blind receive their sight. Now, we remember a time, Pastor, me and Deacon Johnny were talking about it. He shared last night. He said, man, you know, all of what y'all went through wasn't bad. And Deacon Johnny, what I heard in the spirit when you were talking was this. If we don't know nothing else, we know what we don't want.
Yes.
See, because religion don't bring you no results.
No!
That's right.
But he said the blind received their sight. Sister Altamise, would you do me a favor? Just raise your hand. Listen, I know you distract on something. Just raise your hand. Raise both of them, just for a quick minute. I want everybody in this church to see, because some people think we lying and we make up stuff. What did God deliver you from?
What did he deliver me from?
I said, what did you have? What were you diagnosed with?
Blindness.
cancer.
There we go. All right. Praise the Lord. And do you have breast cancer now?
No, I do not.
God, you know what? I don't know what's wrong with me. I feel a pain. I don't know if you ever knew this. I remember one service we was having church. I can't remember Sharon. I talked on the phone or if it was at church. But Sharon said something. She said, Pastor, she said, all Sister Anna needs is for somebody to get an agreement with her.
Right.
And I don't think long after that, I saw Sharon come up the aisle and grab y'all, started shouting and dancing. I was, well, listen, I don't even know if she even know what's going on. But how many of y'all know Sherry, Lord, she's the hope, the spirit of the ability for you to be able to discern.
Yeah.
Watch this now. It is for you to discern good spirits and bad spirits. Watch this. Here's the revelation I got behind this. This blessed me. You may have already known, but it blessed Pastor. God says he gave to the church these gifts so that the church would know what's in the mind of God.
Yes, yes, yes.
See, prior to, I'm going to say it like this, prior to Sherry linking up with Anna, all Anna had to war with was what the doctors were saying.
Yes, yes.
It wasn't until that spirit, the Holy Spirit of discernment hit Sherry, and Sherry says she needs somebody to connect and link up or touch and agree in the spirit realm.
Yes.
So we can hear what God has to say about the matter.
Yes.
Then God comes up and says this, woo, whose report do we believe? My mom, I told y'all to pray for her. My mom, she called me this week and said, Mike, I went to the doctors. I'm going to tell you as much as I can without going too deep. She said, Mike, I went to the doctors and they said they see this. And I said, okay, no problem. I said, now, mom, based on what you just described to me, they called in enough time. You're going to be okay. I said, but I can hear the stress in your voice. And I said, yes, ma'am. I also know that the reason why God is using me to minister to you is because I'm not going through what you're going through. So I said, it's easy for me to minister to you, so just let me minister. And I said, mom, do me a favor. Don't start diagnosing yourself.
Yes. That's right.
I don't think the church getting this. I don't think y'all getting this. See, because there's a reason why Jesus said this in verse 5. He said, the lame receive their sight, the blind receive their sight, and the lame walk, the lepers are cleansed, and the deaf hear, the dead are raised up, and the poor have the gospel preached to them. That's a results-driven ministry. Y'all not talking to me. Not just coming, not church as usual, not formality, because I wanted to go deeper in this, but God said, no, go in a different direction. Now get this. I told my mom, I said, mom, you got to start confessing the word. See, because if you sit around, somebody said it, I think it was Elder Harris. There's a thing, when I was in school, we studied in psychology, people who are psychosomatic.
Yes.
They're not really sick. But their minds tell them something's wrong. And guess this, guess what? Based upon their thought process, their mind, Minister Tracy, starts to manifest even though the doctors will tell you there's nothing wrong with them. So don't tell me about the power of a thought or the power of words. I know what I'm talking about. I have seen people deal with that. Isn't it funny how you don't even know you're sick and you go to the doctors and as soon as they tell you something wrong with you, I feel it. You start manifesting. How about you mess around and believe the true doctor?
Yeah.
Robert, God knew what to allow to happen to move you from religion to relationship. You didn't want to have nothing to do with religion. You saw what religion could do. Religion make you DD. You don't want to follow nobody. Matter of fact, religion had you doing stuff, Pastor. It ain't even in your heart.
Right.
And we read scripture, he said, call us after, they're like, I'll be mad. Coming to church, they make you stay here all day long. Come and talk to me, somebody. God knew what to do to get you in here. Because Robert wasn't coming. I ain't gonna look at Robert no more. And Robert wasn't coming to nobody's church. You ain't gotta tell me, smart man, I'll talk to him. Robert wasn't coming to nobody's church. Let me tell you something. When God allowed affliction to hit his wife, I'm sure Robert prayed a prayer and said, God, if you just heal my... See, let me tell you something. You know how to get to a true brother? Mess with his wife.
That's right.
First lady came home and told me, said, honey, the doctor think he see something on my breast. I ain't no punk. But I will tell you, boy, you talking about well up with some... Man, that's my... That's my... What? So, no, I got to go and pray about this one. I don't know what I'd do if God so fit to take my wife. I believe I survived my God, but it'd be hard.
Yes.
It ain't, I'm just saying, it ain't another woman on the face of earth walk in anointing that first lady walk in.
Yes.
Anna, let's have some fun with your testimony. So God not only heals you, but then also, who would you tell me about that medicine? Good God. Now, watch this. Watch this. God is so awesome. Is it Connie? What's your name? Connie, yeah, don't worry. She like looks like Pastor Smith. If you call me out, don't worry, Connie. I'm gonna tell you after service what the Lord telling me. Is that alright? He like, look, oh, please, Lord, have watch this. I'm moving on. Connie, God is amazing. Thank you, Sherry. And who else was over there? Kiana. I'm going to say that one more time. God is amazing.
Yes.
What's your name, sis? Medina. You know why God gives us the gifts? Daniel. He gives us the gifts so that believers' faith can be increased. And then also unbelievers. Because, Mom, it's nothing like coming to a church service and God use somebody to share something that's going on in your life. You know you ain't told nobody. So you gotta know that email came straight from heaven.
Right.
I don't have time to break it down for you. There's a difference between divination and discerning.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, amen.
Lord, this is good. So he allowed Anna something to hit your body. Now we got the whole family in here.
Yeah.
Running a long time. You know what's so funny? Sometimes when the Holy Spirit be flowing, you can see people, they be like, please God, don't tell that man. Yeah! I'm gonna tell y'all something. Yeah. I feel the same way. I don't want to say it.
Yeah.
You know how many times I got to show me some person, I'll tell a person something, they say it's not me, and then it happened. And you be the main one that they come to, and God will use you to help them through the process.
Yeah.
I'm just being honest with you. My human side of me, I don't want to be bothered. I want to go home and watch Lifetime. Be on the phone explaining the scriptures and praying with you and stuff like that. I want to be eating ice cream, bonbons, like everybody else, lunching. But I can't do it, Mike. Can't do it, Stephanie, when God is dealing with me. Is he a healer?
Yeah.
Okay, hold on. Let's go. That's some pastor. This man right here, gout had hit him.
Yes, it is.
I know what gout can do because I have lived long enough to see it hit my father-in-law and knock him down.
Yes.
Only time in my life I've ever seen my father-in-law cry is when my mother-in-law, my grandmother-in-law passed away. And the other time was, I'll never forget, I went, Bishop called me to come to his house and pray for him. He was laying in the bed, gout had knocked him on his feet. I mean, the pain was so intense, he was in tears. The Lord used us to pray for him. And he started feeling better. So when I found out that Deke was dealing with it, I said, God, this isn't good. I said, well, I'm going to tell you, call my father-in-law. But I haven't seen, long story short, I haven't seen Sister Pastor Embry limping since he got that prayer and received that healing. All I'm trying to say is that God is a healer. 5, 6, 7, 8.
Come back. Hallelujah.
Herb, the Lord wants a results-driven church. Because if things come too easy, people don't appreciate it, Chuck.
That's right.
And until they go through some stuff,
that's right.
They learn to fight for against the choices. I realized kindly today that I'm going through, and I'm going through some of the stuff I went through in my life. It wasn't sent to kill me, it was sent to make me better.
That's it.
You know what to minister when God wants from us? Especially us as preachers. When we start to go through stuff, He really wants to see what's inside of us.
Yeah.
See, when the pressure starts hitting you, Miss Diane, if you can't stop declaring God's word, I heard somebody say, one of our ministers said, because it's not about how we feel, it's about what we believe.
Yeah.
Right.
That's what God is looking for. And when you can speak it before you see it,
yes,
you're making progress.
Yes.
When you can get to the place where you're not moved by what you see,
I'm all elder,
then you're making progress.
That's right.
If you keep being moved by what you see, you're never going to pull the things in the unseen realm into the seen realm.
Right.
Not trying to be deep. I want to be very simple. These benches that we have here, they're here only because somebody first thought of it. It came from the unseen. Someone had enough faith and enough courage to start building and making what they saw here. And now it's in the seen. There's so many more great things that God has for us. And God has shown it to Pastor Smith. I'm not afraid. There are times when I used to be afraid because I knew certain things God would show me. If I have conversations with certain people, I already knew how the conversation was going to go because I know how they think. And I knew, I said, God, I can't talk. I want to talk to somebody. He said, oh, shut up.
That's right. Glory to your name, God.
And you know, visions are, listen. But you got to be able to discern it. You have to be able to pick it up in the Holy Spirit.
Right.
When I come back, because I got to travel, and I'm sharing this with you, there's a time for which I wouldn't share with the church because we weren't mature enough to be able to take this. Something as simple as me saying, I got to go away. I knew that that meant the following week you wasn't coming to church. But I know now we're mature.
Yes.
Pastor's got to go next week. I got to preach in Kentucky. Somebody's been trying to get me for a few years. I've been saying no, but I think this is the season to do it. And then after that, I leave. I come home and I leave again. I got to go to the conference. The church doors will be open. It's important that you all be here because people are still going to be coming.
Yeah.
I can't tell you. Elder Harris can tell you. Deacon Johnny can tell you because he's with me most of the time. 99% of the time he's with me. I was at my dad's church. They had the ceremony and I went down to the basement. One sister stopped me and said, Pastor Smith, thank you so much for streaming live. She said, because I listen to you. We watch you guys every single week. And I was struggling with that for a little bit because I thought, how is she watching us and in church at the same time? And she said, no, I go back and watch it during the course of the week. My husband and I watch it going into work. I got up this morning and turned my phone on. Started blowing up, getting other messages from other members of the body of Christ. I said, Pastor, thank you for doing what you do. I even forgot that I said this. And one Saturday, we was up and I said, we're going to have a buck fest. Somebody texted me and said, hey, Pastor, that service, they gave me the date, took me right in. Awesome. I said, I'd like to say this. You never know how God is moving people. I got people at work who log on. They can't get here, but they log on. I have service. I turn my phone. They send a text message. I enjoy the word. Church, God is taking us places.
Amen.
I hope you want to go.
Yeah.
There's a lot more I have to share, but God took me just in a little bit of a different direction today. Discerning of spirits. There are, let me share this with you. You can keep mentioning, Jeff. There are three gifts that reveal something, three gifts that do something, and three gifts that say something. Again, there are three gifts that reveal something, three gifts that do something, and three gifts that which say something. Three revelation gifts, a word of wisdom. A word of wisdom is when God shares it through somebody else and it's concerning the future. A word of knowledge is when God shares it with someone and it's concerning the past or the present. And then you also have discerning of spirits, which is supernatural insight into the spirit realm. Supernatural insight into the spirit realm. I have a coworker, and we do this every time we're getting ready to speak, Sister Stephen. As people come into the classroom, and you're being seated, we can do it from any position in the room, and we know it's a gift from God. We can tell who's going to be in agreement with us, and we can tell who we're going to have some problems with in terms of just still receiving it. Well, how do we do that, Mr. Tracy? We do it in the spirit realm. I know we're on assignment. Now, why do you think God shows us that? He doesn't show it to us, Connie, so we can say, you know, Connie's got a problem. If you find people who are doing stuff like that and just calling out stuff and talking about people, that's what I meant when I said that. Some people use it and they're gossiping and you're newsy. And watch, notice that the gift is not discerning of people.
Right.
It's discerning of spirits. Because it's not the person, it's the spirit behind it. That's why sometimes when I get calls, I have got to take literally two steps back, breathe deeply, and say, wait a minute, what just happened? Because if I don't do that, Minister Tracy, I might attack the person, which is what the spirit wants. I'm talking about the demonic spirit. God steps back and says, wait a minute. Mm-mm. All they're trying to do, Hunter, is distract you. All they're trying to do, Gene Jones, get you off course. Don't do it. Don't fall for it. Now, if I never take the time to teach you and talk to you about that, you won't know how to pick up on things in the Holy Spirit. I can also be at a table. I'll tell you, in Bible college, we used to have to do exercises, and we learned to do some of this. Never forget, I was getting ready to buy some additional property. We prayed in the Holy Spirit. Pastor Blackwood said, Pastor Smith, the Lord just showed me, you're getting ready to buy some more property, but that's not the one God wants you to buy. How did she know? I didn't tell her. The only person that knew our business was my wife. How did she know the Holy Spirit told her? Look at this. During this age and this time for which we live, and we read about it, but I really don't even know from what I know about the scriptures. I really don't even know if we're going to be alive to really see a lot of what's in the scriptures take place. That's just Pastor Smith. But I will tell you this much. As difficult and challenging times hit the United States of America, if you have the Holy Spirit, you are equipped with everything you need to survive.
Amen.
And what I mean by that, Jonathan, is this. God will tell you where to go to get food.
Amen.
If you really listen, God will even tell you what business deals to accept and which ones to reject. There are times in my life when things, Kiana, look so good. And it seemed like it was God. And if I didn't listen to my inner man, the Holy Spirit elder, I would have made one of the largest mistakes in my life. What I don't know that I've ever shared with this church, maybe other than maybe once, early on in my ministry, I got invited to go to a church. This is when New Bethel couldn't afford to get pastor anything. I went to a church and I preached. We had a wonderful time, a Baptist church. As soon as I sat down, the bishop over that organization said, give me your resume. I'm interviewing pastors for this church. I'd like for you to pastor here. I don't think I've ever told y'all the salary, what type of offer it was, but let's just say I would have been okay. And you know what? Like you, elder, I'm so glad I didn't fall for it. Because let me tell you something. When you really care about souls, money don't matter. I hope whoever needed to hear that hears that. Because let me tell you about the enemy. When you have been a You got a gift from God, and you're gifted. He will dangle all types of stuff in front of you. But you got to be able to know within your heart, within your spirit, within your mind, God wants me to, or God doesn't want me to. And He gives that ability to every last one of us. He said, my sheep know my voice, and a stranger they won't follow. Church, why am I talking about gifts of the Spirit and the benefit of having the Holy Spirit during this season and during this time? Doing that because God wants you to know. That's how He desires for you to live.
Yes.
It's a hard life when you rely on yourself.
Amen.
But when you rely on the Holy Spirit, when you do what the Holy Spirit says to do, things become so much easier. And it's not hard. I hope I haven't said anything to make you think it was mystical. It ain't. It's nothing hard. It's about you having a made up mind to stop and pray and consult the Lord before you do anything. Because these gifts include what God knows. Write this down. And I'm going to let you go. God gives us these gifts. One, because it's His will that we discern the similitude of Christ. two, God gives us this gift so that we can discern the Holy Spirit. I can ask you some questions and tell you some stuff about things that you believe you've never seen, but how do you know it? You discern it in the Spirit. God gives gifts to the church to manifest his presence in the body of Christ on the earth. Ooh, this is good. God gives us gifts to remind us of our dependence upon one another. Isn't that good? Ooh, isn't that good? Can I share this with you all? Our human nature, which naturally operates pridefully, assumes that my perspective is always the right perspective, and usually the only perspective. If you think that way, you are deceiving yourself. Yes, your perspective is valid and essential, but it is not the only right perspective. If others seem insensitive to someone's hurt, it's probably because God has not given them a spiritual gift that includes the mercy giver's heightened sensitivity to others, to see others suffering. Others are not being callous. Please understand this. They simply do not see as you see. You know how some of you all say to me, Elder Smith, I'm so glad I'm not the pastor. I know what you mean when you say that. I do. But understand this. God has given me a gift. There's an anointing upon me.
Amen.
There's a grace given to me to pastor this church.
Amen.
It's like somebody could be in the church and they could be in need. The mercy gift will say this much. They need money and we'll just give.
Right.
But the teaching gift, well, the prophetic gift, will want you to know how you got in that state.
Right.
The mercy gift will be saying, we don't have time for that. Give them some money.
Right.
But the other gifts will be saying, you know what, but help them understand how never to get in that predicament again.
Right.
And notice how none of those gifts, watch this, they can work independently. I'm going to say this. And so, but get this, Sister Geneva. Here's what hit my spirit, Tracy. It's so funny how we don't understand how the gifts work, Mother T. See, mercy and pastor saying, be a blessing, man, is when people go through things, you help them. That's what we're there for.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, there is the teacher side of me, too, that anointing comes upon me to teach, to help you understand. But it's not always that the two are appropriate at the same time.
Right.
See, because when you're hurting, let me use this example. Anna, when you're hungry, you don't want to hear nothing I have to say unless I'm taking you to the grocery store.
That's right.
Amen.
And I can waste my time, Ace, talking to you, but you're not listening because I haven't met your primary need.
Right. Come on, Elder.
Yes.
Yes.
Am I talking?
Amen.
So we got to learn, church. Let's not be so hard on each other.
That's right.
Amen.
If I use, Kiana loves to pray. I might not feel like praying that day, but do I need prayer?
Yes.
So how about I let her pray?
Amen.
And not judge her because she loves to pray.
Right.
Somebody else in here, what? Shamika's someplace else. But she's got a ministry on her for serving.
Yes.
And what's funny about her, and Sister Rita today, they just have a heart for serving. But you know what's funny about them as I talk to them? They can't hear nothing else. I used to wonder, like, why do they say some of the stuff they say? And Mike, it's because I've grown to understand they really function just in that gift, primarily.
Right.
So many times, if I didn't know what I knew in the Holy Spirit, if I said, let's go left, they would think, how come we're not going right? They're not being disobedient intentionally. I just had to come to understand the gifts. Now that I know how they work, I know how to get to them. It's a shame you're upstairs because I know they don't want to talk after service. But I know how to reach them. Over a period of time, we become the best of friends because I've learned in the Spirit how to deal with them. So like I said, there are other examples I could give you. You'll see the gifts flowing. But learn, why am I saying this to the church? Learn to appreciate each other. Last night, man, you taught, the Lord used you in a manner for which there was nothing else for pastor to say. I learned through discerning in the Holy Spirit that though I'm the pastor, I don't always have to have something to say. sometimes God wants me to lead by example, Chuck, and just say, it's time to go home.
Amen.
I know some of y'all couldn't receive that, I know. Because you think it's always about sitting around after church and just talking. No, sometimes it's good just to shut down and go home. Because I also know, too, from being in church, born in church all my life and pastoring this church, that sometimes some of the worst problems take place when people don't go home after church. Because what happens is the anointing lifts, and then you show up. That's why if you follow your pastor, Deacon Johnny can tell you, in most cases, I'm always communicating with him because he's my adjutant. But there are some times, the Holy Spirit will say, get in your car and go home. It's 2:21. I'm gonna let you go. Boy, it's been a good something. It's good. I just been some strong word today. Good, good. Mature word. Mature. You would have to be spiritually dead not to see God transition your pastor in this church. You would have to be. We all of us are operating at a totally different level. If you're really serious, you're gonna stick around. I will tell you this. Come on, let's stand. I invite you to stand to your feet. We're done. Take this one down. One more thing. Thank you. There's so much on my mind, but I'll be here today. I want to talk to you. Y'all ready to grow? Lord. All right. Those of you who have visited us via streaming live, we want to take some time to tell you thank you so much for supporting us. It's because of people like you that give you generous donations and you keep logging on that enable us to do the things that we do. I only have one more message for you, and that is this. If you don't know the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, and I'm basing it upon what's written in Romans chapter 10, verses 9 and 10, all you have to do is confess with your mouth and believe in your heart, and the Bible says, thou shalt be saved. What is it that you're confessing? That you're a sinner without Him? What is it in addition to that that you're confessing? That He died for your sins, He rose again on the third day, and because of that, your sins are covered. Now, the only way that that disqualifies you, or you become disqualified, is if you have a way of forgiving your sins yourself. I can't, so I need Him. I invite you to do the same. Now, watch this. As a result of giving your life to the Lord and sitting under good preaching and good teaching, watch your life change. And that promised abundant life that Jesus talked about in the book of John, it will take place quicker than you think. But you got to find yourself a good church home. If you're anywhere near Maryland, I know a real good pastor. If you're anywhere in Maryland, I know a real good pastor. If you're anywhere in Maryland, I know a real good pastor. Located at 5116, y'all a little slow on the draw. Located at 5116 Ricestown Road, Baltimore, Maryland. Yours truly is a senior pastor, amen. God bless you. But if you can't get here, go to find a good church home. Allow God to lead you to a good church home and make sure you apply that word. In our best English as we close out on today, helping our congregation. You ain't seen nothing yet. The best is yet to come. God bless you. We love you and be encouraged.